It's Thursday, Chargers. We hope you all found your correct spot for either testing or grade level activities yesterday.
It's National Get to Know Your Customers Day.
It's October 20th, the 294th day of this year.
It's rapper Snoop Dogg's birthday.
It's DP News.
And it
starts now.
On Wednesday the 26th, there was a presentation on the Naval Reserve Officer Training Corps Scholarship Program at two different times in the Career Center. The scholarship pays full tuition and fees, provides an allowance of $100,000 for books, and a monthly stipend ranging from $200 to $450 for 4 years of college. Visit the Career Center to learn more. Also, the Fiber Arts Club meets on Thursdays. Today they will be working on a crochet bunny. Tomorrow, SBCC and Universe of Colorado Boulder will be here. Stop by the Career Center if you'd like to learn more and get a pass.
Today, CalSOAP is hosting a personal statement workshop at the Franklin Elementary School Library from 6 to 7 p.m. This workshop is geared toward juniors and seniors, but sophomores and freshmen are also encouraged to attend. CalSOAP will be at our campus on Tuesday to provide important financial aid information to all seniors in their government or econ classes. If you're not enrolled in one of these classes, you can attend any of the presentations, periods 1 through 6 in the EPAC during your free period.
The pep rally is happening tomorrow during lunch in the Greek. Seniors should wear white, juniors should wear blue or navy, sophomores should wear gold or yellow, and freshmen should wear black. Lunch will be 52 minutes long. After your lunch, report to your sixth period class where you will stay until school ends at 1:58. There will be no fifth period tomorrow. Also, Red Ribbon Week is next week. Activities, as well as opportunities to pledge a drug and alcohol-free lifestyle, will be happening all week at lunch during the Greek.
Remember, this year is the 50th anniversary of our school. Here's a video highlighting the last 50 years.
I thought love was only true in fairy tales, meant for someone else but not for me. Our love was out to get me, that's the way it seemed. Disappointment haunted all my dreams.
Check. pull me closer in the backseat of your Rover that I know you can't afford. Bite that.
Here, I'm Jeffrey Chow with another Chow Chow.
Pull the sheets right off the corner of the mattress that you stole from your roommate back in Boulder. We ain't ever getting older.
The day I met you, I forget just why I left you. I was insane. Stay.
That's all the time we have for you today, DP. Thanks for watching.
We all know how it feels to be judged, whether it's at school, it's at work, it's at home, because of the clothes that we wear, the sports that we play, the music that we listen to, the things that we like to do, the group of friends that we hang out with, maybe it's the mistakes that we made. We all know what it feels like to be judged. I get thousands and thousands of emails, messages, comments, posts from students all across the country talking to me about how it feels to be not accepted by one group or not a part of another group, that their school is plagued by cliques and people judging other people. It's like you walk into the lunchroom and you know exactly where you can sit and where you can't sit, and everybody's got their little place. You know what's crazy to me? That over 42% of all students say that they've been bullied online. 3 million students nationally are absent every single month from school because they don't feel safe. Every day in our country, there's an average of over 5,000 students who have attempted suicide, and that's just grades 7 through 12. Where do these numbers stem from? I think it comes from the way that we judge each other. Judgment isn't just a high school problem. The way that we judge each other, it's a society problem. If you don't believe me, just look at social media. Look at the things that people write about each other on Facebook, the comments on Instagram. It's the things that people tweet at celebrities. I mean, have you ever read the comments on a YouTube video? The world, it's more connected than ever. But bullying, cliques, prejudice, those things run rampant in our schools across the country. A lot of the reason judgment exists is because of the differences in how we value each other. You know, we hold someone as more valuable because they play sports or because they get straight A's. Or you judge somebody because of, you know, the neighborhood that they come from or the money that their parents make. Or we judge someone because of the music that they listen to or the color of their skin, their ethnic background, or their sexual preference. You know the way you kids hate how adults judge you? It's the way that they look at you for being different, for being young, for being unique. It's the same look, it's the same exact thing that you do to each other every single day. If you're the kind of person who judges someone, all it is a pathetic little habit that starts when you're a kid, and by the time you're an adult, you can't change because it's so rooted in who you are. It's like there's this totem pole that we base people on, like there's this top and this middle and this bottom, and we base people based upon our own value system, and wherever you're at on the totem pole, that's how you treat people. I mean, I've been on all sides of it. I remember walking into high school as a new student with purple hair and a Green Day t-shirt on, and then I became a four-sport varsity athlete, and I thought I was more important than everyone else just because I played sports. I thought judgment would end after high school, but it doesn't. I mean, it continues on into the adult world. There's nothing that cracks me up more than when I walk into a room filled with adults and I watch them judge me for what I look like. I mean, judgment, it's something that you're gonna face for the rest of your life. And you can sit there and pretend it's not you. You can pretend that you haven't been bit by this poison. You can pretend that you don't have this little totem pole for the way that you evaluate people and the way that you judge people. But you have to realize something. All of us, we all have our own prejudices. We all make our own judgments. We have to understand that everyone has value. Everyone matters. I mean, if you're cutting yourself because you don't feel like you belong at school, you do. You matter. If you don't want to show up every morning because you feel like nobody hears you and nobody cares about you, if you're watching this and you feel like a ghost, you have to understand something. Every one of us matters. We all matter. But if each of us can understand that we've all got value, that we all matter, that's when we begin to change the culture of our schools.